I think the mother and the baby are lucky that they're alive.
A memory that was supposed to be magical turned into a nightmare for Susie Bigler. May 27th, the day her first baby was born.
I had never had a baby before, so I didn't really know what to expect.
Court documents show Bigler was at the Baby's Choice Center in Roland with midwife Deborah Dish. After several hours of labor, the problem started. Bigler's family members started to worry. According to an affidavit, Dish got in a family member's face, yelling at her that she had 36 years of experience and tried to make the family leave the room.
She was like, "Oh yeah, everything's fine. Don't worry. This is normal."
That trust gone when she heard this.
She looked up at me and said, "We need to do an episiotomy, and I've never done one before."
Shortly after the procedure, Bigler's baby was born, but the complications continued. She says her baby was not breathing and was blue. And when Dish started CPR, Bigler says Dish dropped the child.
You know, I was just saying, "Spencer, I need you to wake up. I need you to talk to mom. You know, I need you to cry for me."
After what Bigler described as what felt like a long time, her baby started breathing.
They hand him to me and I stand up to move to the bed, and blood just pours out of me.
Bigler and her son spent days in the hospital recovering. Today, Attorney General Mike Hunter filing a charge of unauthorized practice of medicine.
The administering of Pitocin without a prescription, and the individual also performed an episiotomy. The facts, the evidence that we collected really compelled us to file these charges.
This is not the first time Dish has been in trouble. 2 years ago, she was barred from working as a midwife in Arkansas. We reached out to Dish but did not get a response. The Midwife Society of Oklahoma says they trust the justice system and encourage all midwives to follow the laws.